and lost her most important credential, her credibility.
We were presenting her as a thoughtful, gentle, private woman, and essentially, you know, the defense would have been able to paint her as Mark Arden.
And that's exactly how it played out in front of a grand jury. All three victims testified that Simona was the woman who disguised herself as a police officer and robbed them at gunpoint. Simona was indicted, and her bail was set at $1 million. She couldn't come up with the money and remained in jail.
Did you move some plants around?
They've got three witnesses.
No, not really.
Identified your car.
Can I turn it to the
which
news?
Of them seems
yes,
like
ma'am.
A pretty good case. Did you understand that?
Yeah, I do understand that.
But what Simona didn't understand was why Nassau County Police...
94, your high tomorrow. Lows tonight, still pretty toasty, only dropping into the 60s. We'll see a slight chance for some showers and storms well west of the metro overnight tonight, early tomorrow. Better chance for storms Wednesday night and Thursday night.
Early morning running this week.
Yes.
All right, Caitlin, thanks.
That's our report at 5. Thanks for joining us.
We're back here in 30 minutes with more local news. Up next, World News Tonight.
This is an editorial from KETV's president and general manager, Sean Oswald.
I will cut the audio out of it. Well, I turned the audio off, apparently.
The time is now for parents to think about one aspect of back to school, COVID-19 vaccinations for their teenagers. It's a very personal decision. That's why we took note of an op-ed piece by Dr. Jim Sutphin, superintendent of Millard Public Schools. Sutphin notes that keeping schools open and safe is a responsibility we all share. He encourages families to gain as much information as they can from trusted sources like pediatricians and family physicians and make a decision for or against vaccination based on solid knowledge. We echo his respect for freedom of choice, but also his concern about more COVID-19 disruptions in the fall.
Come here,
as Dr. Sutphin writes, the power and responsibility lies where it should, in the hands of each individual. Please check KETV.com where you can get the facts on the vax.
Replaces and remodels to create a bathroom just for you.
Tonight, President Biden making global headlines just a short time ago. What he said about his upcoming summit with Russian President Vladimir Putin. The two leaders about to come face to face in Geneva. The president, after once saying he stared into Putin's eyes and told him, "I don't think you have a soul." Our Cecilia Vega asking the president about that today and about this high-stakes meeting. Will the president draw red lines with Putin? And it all comes after a key summit with NATO leaders on China and Russia. And tonight, the fate of two Americans imprisoned in Russia, with Putin now signaling he would be willing to discuss a prisoner swap. Mac Gutman back here at home tonight with the family begging for help for their son to come home. Also tonight, the new concern as the U.S. is set to hit that awful milestone. 600,000 American lives lost to COVID. Tonight, new concerns about the highly contagious Delta variant first seen in India. Now 90% of the cases in the U.K. And authorities here warning it could become dominant in the U.S. And the new study tonight on how effective the vaccines are against this particular variant. From Washington, D.C. up into the Northeast at this hour, the severe storms as we come on the air tonight. Also, the dangerous heat in the West, growing concern over the fire dangers. And we're also watching two tropical systems near the U.S. tonight, one off the East Coast, the other in the Gulf. Rob Marciano standing by. The chaos in midair, authorities say an off-duty flight attendant threatening to take down the plane. The pilot calling on the intercom for passengers to help. Overseas tonight, Benjamin Netanyahu is out after 12 years in office, out as prime minister by one vote. Tonight, Netanyahu now vowing to bring down the new government. Here in the U.S., the deadly shooting at a grocery store, all of it, authorities say, over masks. The cashier did not survive. The images coming in tonight, the massive chemical plant fire, families nearby ordered to evacuate. And celebrating a popular character actor